What's going on, everybody? It's your boy A-Dubb, and I'm back again. I got some great news. I'm gonna be putting up quite a few videos today, by the way. I'm just feeling like a video. I'm just in a video making mood, guys. So the first video I want to share with you guys is, see, I have my UltraStudio Mini recorder connected to my Thunderbolt input on my Mac and HDMI out, and we are plugged into this camera right here, the GH4. So I'm going to go into OBS so I can show you guys something real cool. Look at this. We are live streaming. Let me do a screen capture so you guys see this. I screen capture with QuickTime, guys. New screen recording. Start screen recording, boom. We're screen recording. So you guys can see I'm looking at you, and right now I should be looking at myself in there. It's weird. In here, it's so weird. But anyway, I got my OBS to work, and I want to make a quick video to show you guys how I got it to work, because I know I can't be the only person in the world who had this problem. So of course, just like every other video that I make, you know, when I figure something out, I want to share it with somebody, because I didn't find a video online to show me how to do this. So I want to show you guys in case anybody else is having this problem with the UltraStudio Mini recorder, as well as help the people at Blackmagic, even though they got enough money. So I'm gonna show you guys what I did and how I did it. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to uninstall the Blackmagic software so you guys can see exactly how I did this. So of course, to uninstall it, you need to put this little thing in here to have the uninstaller. So as you can see, let's go to system preferences first so you can verify that it's there. You can see it's there, and I clicked on it, and you can see that the system now recognizes it. All right, and you guys saw the message that I was getting before. So this is what I did, guys. I'm gonna show you guys. First, I'm gonna uninstall the software. All right, this is what you guys gotta do, all right? I'm gonna stop my recording right now. Stop my screen recording right now. This is what you guys gotta do. Show you guys what you gotta do here. All right, first, I'm gonna uninstall it. And the reason why I'm not showing you guys this through the screen capture program is because the computer has to do its thing. So I'm uninstalling the program right now. Right now, boom, I'm gonna click the uninstaller and take my word for it, enter my password, and I'm uninstalling the Blackmagic software from my computer right now. I actually could be videoing all of this, actually. New screen recording. Boom, boom. All right, so it's uninstalling. It says the drivers have been successfully uninstalled. All right, so it says the drivers have been successfully uninstalled. I'm gonna highlight, eject this disk right here. Ejected it. Now let's go and check to make sure they in fact aren't there. So you go, system preferences, and you see I only have three icons there. So the Blackmagic software is gone and off my computer. Just double check so you guys can see. It used to live right here next to my Serato DJ Pro. It's gone. You don't see it on this screen. You see the OBS, but you don't see it. And you don't see it on this screen. All right, just to show you guys again, if you go into OBS and you click on it, and Blackmagic UltraStudio device, it's actually still there. It's grayed out now. And now that I ungrayed it out, you don't even see it anymore, because it's like gone. All right, the software is not there anymore. So, all right, this is what I did, guys. First thing you gotta do is go to the software. Go to the Blackmagic Studio. Sheesh, just typing too fast, my own good. All right, you go to the support. Pick the device category that you got, download the software, fill out the name and stuff, yeah, boom, type in your information, you know, A-Dubb Productions. Nothing really secretive for you guys to see here. I can show you guys all of this stuff. It's not that big of a deal. But we'll gray out my phone number. Pennsylvania. During. I have the UltraStudio Mini Recorder. Serial number. I had already did that already. So, boom. Now it's, I'm just going to download it. Download only. So it's going to automatically start downloading. See it's going. And you see up here it's downloading. And you see the thing went to my downloads folder. So after it downloads, guys, I'm going to open it up. And the computer's going to have to shut down. So show you guys that real fast. Boom, boom, boom. It's done downloading. So I'm going to X out of all of this. Right? Quit Safari. And then I'm going to go into my downloads folder and double click, opened up, there's Blackmagic, clicked on that, open it up. Now this is where the computer is going to shut off, so I'm going to stop the recording. Alright, stop that and help it start, name it something real fast before it closes down. Alright, so, X out of that. And it should be, is it installing already? Oh yeah, double click on here. Did it do it already? All right, now I gotta install desktop. Click on that, it's gonna install. And after this screen, after I install it, it's gonna turn off. I'm just going through the regular install. Like you guys all did this already. Put your password. Alright, continue installation. It's going to go through the motions and then it's going to shut down. Shut down the computer. Whew, I'm so relieved, guys. So when the computer turns back on, that's when the steps that you have to follow kick in. Alright, so just bear with me right here. I'm going through the whole installation. I know it's a lot that I'm showing you guys, but just bear with me here. Because if you're having this problem, this is exactly what you want to do. All right. The computer's going to turn off and turn back on. I'm probably going to fast forward past that part or cut to that part. Better yet, I'm just going to let it play all the way through because I want you guys to see what happened so you guys can trust that it works 100%. Oh, yeah. By the way, if you're not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe at this moment. Hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. Successfully installed, restart, move to trash, move the installation files to trash, boom, boom. Now my computer's gonna install, you must restart the computer, okay. Restart the computer then, do that then, do it. So the computer just shut down on its own. Right. Just shut down. So we're gonna wait till it turns back on. So excited, guys. This is going to open up a whole new bunch of possibilities for us, YouTube channel. I'm going to go. I have to go to the Apple Store today because I lost my cable that connects via Thunderbolt. Ethernet, it goes Ethernet to Thunderbolt. I can't find this thing. I don't know where I had it. I'm normally good with those things. I don't know what just happened. My camera just randomly stopped recording. It was crazy. All right. So the computer just finished. Just restarted. The computer just restarted. It's loading up. Loading up on the MacBook Pro. I just get excited when I can make a video that actually helps people because I know I had this problem. So, all right. So now, guys, before you go to System Preferences and open up that Elgato, this is what you want to do. You go to System Preferences, right? And you see the Elgato, the Blackmagic is back. Let me record this. Let me do a screen record. Boom. Boom. Start new screen record. Okay. So, you see that the Blackmagic desktop video is back. Don't click on it yet. You got to go into System Preferences. Then go into Security and Privacy. After you go into Security and Privacy, go to General, right? Wait a minute. privacy, general. Oh, I already did it, so it's not gonna let me do it again. Okay, so what you gotta do here, guys, is not let me do it again because I did it already, so I think it's gonna be fine. I had to go to general and then app store and unidentified developers. Right at the bottom of here, I didn't even have to unlock this. Right at the bottom of here was the software, the Blackmagic Design Studio software developers. I had to actually trust them. I had to allow them to be able to access my computer. And that's the reason why it was unable to open. So right now, if I go back to the system preferences panel and I click on it, I should be seeing my device. There it is. And I can go in here and I can change from SDI to HDMI, which is awesome. I want to output to 1080 SD. So yeah, it can do 1080 SD, guys. I was originally told that the Blackmagic can't do 1080. Do I want to do anamorphic or do I want to do letterbox? I think I'm going to do letterbox because I like the way it looks. So 1080 SD or 720 SD. Let's do 1080. Or SD to HD. Wow. Interesting. A lot of different options here. I'm going to try 1080. Actually, you know what? Let me just keep it simple. It's file size small. 720. Okay, so HDMI, and now when I save that, I go out, you see right here, it says input HDMI as opposed to SDI, and I'm good to go. And just to verify that, let's open up OBS. And here I am talking in OBS, talking to you. No, that's actually a web camera. No. So let me change it. See Blackmagic Studio Recorder, boom. And it's glitching. It does that sometimes. I have no idea why, guys. I don't know why. But what I do normally when it does that, I close OBS. And I open OBS back up. And it should be okay. But what I'm going to... Let me close OBS. Unplug. This thing isn't perfect, guys. Unplug the UltraStudio Mini. Plug it back in. Then turn on OBS. I should be straight now. Hopefully. It's still glitching. I don't know why. It does that every now and again. This thing is not... It's very... Still flawed, guys. But this is very frustrating to see this doing this. Oh, you know what? Let me stop the screen recording. That might be why. It might be interfering. Alright, so I'm going to stop the screen recording, guys. Let me see if that helps. Name this one again. Save. Because the computer's doing a lot right now, so. Let me see if that has had anything to do with it. System prefs. Now let me open up OBS. It's still glitching. Which is weird. Because my camera stopped recording again when I unplugged this, I believe, but now it's working fine again, guys. You can see me on the screen, you can see me over here, and it is working flawlessly. I'm gonna do a screen capture again to see if that was what was causing it to be problematic. Screen recording. Boom, boom. No, it's running fine. As you guys see, I have a little template at the bottom right here I'm going to be playing with and messing around with. I can drag these layers to the bottom. I love this OBS software, man. And keep that at the bottom of the screen. This OBS software is hot. I don't know why anybody would even have to pay for anything else, because this is so, like, once you figure out how to use it, it's, like, so user-friendly, man. Like, it really is. It seems complicated, but it really isn't. But so anyway, I hope that helps somebody. That's what you got to do if you're having the problem And the UltraStudio Mini software, where it says no video device detected. I think that was the message I was getting. So yeah, that's how you fix it, guys. Hope this was helpful. Like, comment, subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and share it with your friends if you found this video helpful. All right, peace out. Leave a comment down below.